Hello and welcome to this Bioprocess International Ask the Expert webcast. I'm your host, Leah Roslin, the online editor for Bioprocess International. Before we get started, just a couple of notes. This webcast is being recorded and will be made available for replay in the multimedia section of our website. We've muted the audio lines, but we welcome you to type in your questions for a speaker in the question and answer window on your screen. After the presentation, we will begin the question and answer portion, and I will ask our speaker your questions. Your questions in the question and answer window will only be visible to myself and our speaker. So thank you for joining us today. It is now my pleasure to introduce our speaker, Lauren Siekstra from Thermo Fisher Scientific.
Okay, welcome and thank you for listening in to this webinar on the advantages of anti-base selectivity in the purification of next generation biologics. So I'll start off with actually an introduction on the Capture Select technology. On which our products are based on, which is a platform technology we developed over the last several years. Thereafter, I'll focus on some new products which we've developed for the purification of new generation molecular entities. Because as you're all aware, right, that landscape is rapidly changing. So if you look to 10 years back, the majority of biological molecules in development were antibody-based, and they were actually basically standard monoclonals. So the purification of those type of molecules, of course, is usually done with protein A. However, if you look to recent, let's say, clinical trials and the pipeline of global biologics, we see a lot of different modalities popping up there, right, from recombinant proteins to gene therapy and viral vectors, cell therapies, but as well a diversified antibody landscape. And of course, moving away from monoclonals means that all of these new biological entities actually lack a standard purification platform, which means that these products usually being purified by multi-step processes, which you can see depicted on the left-hand side for a non-affinity capture step. If you use these type of processing steps to purify your biotherapeutic, then even if you have, let's say, three processing steps and an 80% yield, which is not too bad, then you're throwing away half of the product which you're cultivating in upstream when you're going to actually purify the molecule. So what the purpose is of our platform technology is to actually move the purification protocol from the left side of the screen to the right, which means that we actually have the possibility by introducing affinity capture to reduce the amount of steps in your purification process. Reducing number of steps means that you increase your product yield by lowering the loss. You reduce the development time because you already start with a fairly pure product after your affinity capture, which means that you only need to do some polishing steps, which in the end, of course, reduces the time to market for a final biopharmaceutical. So what we've developed as a platform is what we call the Capture Select technology, and it's basically affinity through antibody selectivity. So we use single domain antibodies, which is the smallest binding antibody binding domain of about 15 kilodalton, and we only use the three CDRs and the four framework regions to develop and make our products. Due to our unique screening technology, we can target the specificity of that binding event, engineering mild elution, as well as stability of the affinity ligand. The real key as well here in developing these type of products is that we produce them in Baker's yeast, so in Saccharomyces cerevisiae, which is an animal origin-free production process, which enables the flawless scale-up of these type of products towards being able to be implemented in GMP processes. The products we've actually have developed are currently in commercial purification process, and we've driven these type of developments through our custom development program over the last, 15 years or so. So the development of an affinity ligand then enables the one-step selectivity for challenging purification needs. And that's what you can see on this specific slide, where a couple of examples are presented for example, a recombinant factor 8, an antibody fragment, or an AAV particle, all products which actually are currently commercially available and in commercial processes. And whether it's let's say a highly complicated recombinant protein or let's say an antibody fragment produced in a very crude feedstock or the AAV on the right hand side, you can see that by a simple bind, wash and elute step, you can go from a very dirty feedstock, washing away the impurities, and then very nicely eluting your target from that resin. Since, let's say, around 15 years or so, we've been working on different areas, right, knowing that the landscape of biopharmaceuticals is changing. So we've mainly focused on developing products for antibody-derived therapeutics, biosimilars or recombinant proteins and plasma proteins, viral vectors, as well as vaccines. So the development of these type of processes is run according to our platform process, and our platform process is developed according to five main steps, which go from a library up to a resin suitable for GMP processes and three steps in the middle. So we either start with a library which we construct, or we actually have pre-existing libraries available, or multi-target libraries which we've developed for customers. From that library construction, which contains a plethora of monoclonal antibodies, we can then actually move to the second step, which is our work package 2, which goes into the lead screening. So we'll then identify via our sophisticated high-throughput screening methodology specific ligands which bind to the specific target of interest, where we can actually look at the binding kinetics, so the on and the off rates, look at the elution capabilities of specific monoclonals, as well as stability. From that point, we would actually move to the next phase, which is we would produce a prototype. So we would actually make a prototype resin and select, let's say, the best prototype in work package 3, finally ending up with a work package 4 program, which develops the final lead on the final backbone. Once we develop that final lead, we would move into what we call upscaling to make that resin suitable for GMP processes, which means that we would do process validation, a leakage ELISA development to be able to detect the ligand, as well as produce a regulatory support file. So all of our products, whether we do it for custom development or whether we develop it for, let's say, general purposes, follow these five-step process program. So in the last years, you've as well experienced probably that the landscape is changing for antibody-derived therapeutics. So this is a slide which was in a publication fairly recently, which only describes, let's say, the bispecific formats. And you can see that landscape is becoming really extremely diverse. So what we've developed for that are supporting antibody purification resins. So as opposed to going for, let's say, a proteinate type of binding, which binds to the CH2-CH3 interface, we actually looked for alternative binding sites which we could target for developing new affinity resins. And for that, we developed a suite of three different resins binding to three different domains. So on the top right-hand side, you can see our product, which is called CH1XL, which binds to the CH1 domain of antibodies, which makes it an ideal platform for Fabs because it doesn't bind to the free light chains. So in this case, you would immediately purify your Fab in a single one-step process. This is independent of whether it's a Kappa or a Lambda Fab, so it would actually purify all antibody fragments. Moving one below is what we call the Kappa XP product, which has been developed specifically for Fab fragments as well as bispecific. It binds to the constant region of the light chain, meaning that it binds all Kappa domains. So unlike Protein L, which doesn't do all Kappa domains, the Kappa XP binds to all Kappa light chains, as well making it extremely suitable for either Fab fragments or bispecifics, or actually as well monoclonals, right, if the Protein A binding site is in one way or another disrupted. On the down also on the last one, you can see the FCXL, which has been developed specifically for Fc fusion proteins or if the protein A binding site is disrupted in bispecifics, which as well has incorporated myelodeletion. What we recently launched is actually a new product, which is the improvement of the FCXL, which is what we call Capture Select FCXP. And again, it's got the same, let's say, great properties of the FCXL product, right? So it will bind to all human IgG subclasses. It's got built-in myelodeletion as opposed to protein A. It's excellent scalable, and of course, it's all non-animal derived. The advantage of FCXP is that it has a higher binding capacity than the FCXL, which you can see on this slide, where we actually have got data on the residence time versus dynamic binding capacity, clearly demonstrating that the dynamic binding capacity at 10% breakthrough is around the 45-50 grams per liter at 4 minute residence time, while on the right hand side you can see an SDS page of a rituximab in a one step purification, clearly as well noting that with FC XP as well as with FCXL, you do not bind any light chains, right, which you might have if you are actually producing an antibody as well. So as I said, you know, high binding capacity and high purity in a single step with FCXP. Another product we recently launched targets IgEs, and IgEs are specifically an upcoming new monoclonal product, because through their epsilon constant region, which is different than IgGs, it's supposed to actually provide a better immune effector function and better tumor access. And that prompted us to develop an IgE affinity resin, which can be used to, again, in one single step, purify IgEs from complex feedstocks. It binds to the CH4 domain of human IgGs. It's got an excellent binding capacity, efficient elution at pH 3, and it's got the same building, of course, scalability and non-animal derivedness through our Saccharomyces cerevisiae production system. Here again, a chromatogram on the left showing the very sharp elution peak from the IgE resin, and on the right-hand side, again, an SDS page which demonstrate the high purity in a single step for IgEs, as well showing, you know, that we do not co-purify any light chains as well in this for this specific IgE. Moving on from the antibody landscape, right, where we've developed a couple of very interesting new products, we as well have the largest affinity portfolio for recombinant proteins and hormones, right? So we've developed products for FSH, albumin for albumin fusions for extension of half-life, HCG, TPA, TSA, and human growth hormone. And specifically, for example, on the TSA resin, these are actually customer data generated by Genexin in Korea, who is using our TSA resin to purify this specific hormone, dramatically improving the yield by cutting out steps, right? So they actually improved their recovery from 46% to 71% by implementing this resin. But what we as well developed is a new product, right, for Capture Select, what we call Capture Select Factor 10 affinity resin. It's to purify coagulation factor 10, again, purifying it from complex feed materials, whether it's from plasma or recombinant. And the real key part here is that it's got very high selectivity, right? So it will not bind to other human plasma proteins or host cell proteins in your recombinant feed, as well as a mild elution at neutral pH using EDTA. And the main reason why we can use EDTA is because we've developed the ligand to bind in the presence of calcium. So by means of adding a little bit of EDTA, you can actually disrupt the binding. Again, excellent scalability and non-animal derived, of course, because of our platform production system. And here again, on a very nice chromatogram, as well as SDS page on the single-step purification of factor 10, where you can see the very sharp elution peak by means of the EDTA trick and elution. And on the right-hand side, an SDS page, which clearly demonstrates that from this feedstock, which got a lot of other proteins in there. You can very nicely in a single step purify your factor 10 heavy chain, your factor 10A heavy chain, and your factor 10 light chain in one single step. Moving on from recombinant proteins, as said, the landscape is rapidly changing. So, and one of the areas which has really boomed during the last years is, of course, gene therapy and viral vector production. And for this, we've developed a couple of different products to target the gene therapy market, ranging from our adeno-associated virus product lines, so AVX9 and 8. Through AD5, so adenovirus 5 purification resin, through a recently launched Capture Select Baku Clear, as well as an Oligo DT resin, which I'll go into in the next slide. Together with our Capture Select CTEC, which can be used for CTEC proteins and VLPs as a platform, this actually nicely broadens our portfolio for gene therapy and vaccine manufacturing. So this slide depicts actually a typical process on the top side which one of our customers was using to purify AAV9. And you can clearly see that this was a multiple step process to come from harvest up to the final drug product. And by working with them and having them implement the AAV9 purification resin for adeno-associated virus, we could drastically remove the processing steps, as well as increase their yield and do a cost reduction up to a factor of 6 by cutting out steps and increasing yield. Clearly demonstrating that these type of products are the go-to solution for adeno-associated virus manufacturing. Adding to that, of course, one of the key areas in any biologics manufacturing process is that you want to remove your advantageous viruses, right, which can actually be in your manufacturing. And of course, one of the advantages of using Affinity to purify these type of virus particles is that by virtue of the Affinity step, you have built-in viral clearance. So this was actually a study which we performed in collaboration with Regenex, Texel and Mokfi, and ourselves, where we demonstrated that by incorporating the Affinity, and this in this case with AAVX resin, into an AAV manufacturing process, we could obtain efficient viral clearance, right, from RNA enveloped to DNA non-enveloped to RNA non-enveloped to DNA enveloped viruses, sometimes actually going to about 6 logs removal of advantageous virus. Up to, and that was the worst case was 2.5 for the RNA non-enveloped, really demonstrating that Affinity can aid the removal as well as contribute to viral clearance, which demonstrates the strength of the technology. So another key product which we actually released 2-3 months ago as a commercial GMP suitable resin is for messenger RNA. This is not based upon the Capture Select technology, so this is not based on the single domain technology, but it is a product which again demonstrates the breadth of Thermo Fisher Scientific products which we offer to purify new type of therapeutics. In this case, targeted towards messenger RNA, which is currently as well a booming new technology to provide vaccines. And in this case, what we've done is we've used a simple mRNA capture through AT base pairing. It's easy to use, so you can actually load it in NaCl and elute in water. Dynamic binding capacity is up to 5 mg per mil for 4,000 base pair messenger RNA, with excellent recovery and excellent scalability, as well as being non-animal derived. It's based upon the porous technology, so the 50 micron rigid porous bead, and as said, it uses a poly DT ligand to be able to capture poly A messenger RNA. So depicted in this slide are some performance data. Again, the package is broader than this, but this is simply a snapshot of it. And what you can nicely see here is that the mRNA binding capacity is of course dependent upon the base pairs, which is logical, right? But as well on the right-hand side, you can see that it's excellent in terms of cycling, as well as excellent in terms of cleaning and caustic stability, really demonstrating that this can be a platform for poly-A messenger RNA purification for these new molecular modalities, messenger RNA-derived vaccines. Next to that, and again, this is another interesting launch we recently did only 2 weeks ago, is related to baculovirus and baculovirus production and expression system. As you all know, right, the baculovirus system is really a versatile and robust eukaryotic expression system, which is extremely well suited for VLPs, right? So it's got a lot of advantages to it in terms of safety profile, short production times, high yields. It's scalable. But one of the challenges of this system is that you usually will have a presence of baculovirus co-produced with the target. So if you make a VLP, you actually will have baculovirus as well, which is not VLP, in your feed stream, which is pretty complex to separate because they resemble quite the VLP which you want to purify. So together with IBET in Portugal, we embarked upon a method to see whether or not we could make capture select affinity ligands to be able to remove baculovirus from VLP the particles. So this is actually one of the conclusions of the paper. The paper is cited below here, and it's been just recently published in Separation and Purification Technology. And what you can see on this slide is on the left-hand side, you can see the VLP recovery, and in this case, it was a influenza VLP produced in baculovirus. And you can see that with this resin which we developed, we can get a yield of between 60 to 70% of the VLP, but a removal of baculovirus particles of about 80%, further depicted by the microscopy images on the right, where you can see on the top three pictures the VLPs together with the baculovirus particles, and on the lower left three pictures the clarified VLPs after a removal of the baculovirus with CapsuLac BacuClear affinity resin. Really demonstrating for the first time that affinity as well can be used for scavenging of components, as well as hopefully enabling the further development of the baculovirus system for producing VLPs and removing baculovirus. So besides the developments and the new products we recently launched, we have a pipeline of capture select affinity products we are always working on. We divide them in therapeutics, therapeutic proteins, antibody types, as well as on the right-hand side, viruses and vaccines. And as I said, if your target is not on the list, we as well have got a very comprehensive custom resin development program, which, as I said, will follow that five-step process from library construction up to finally delivering a bioprocessed product. If there's any target on this list and there is an interest from you in the audience, we're always happy to collaborate to getting these products, let's say, fit for purpose and up to the next steps together with our customers. Interesting developments we have on the right-hand side are, for example, products we're trying to develop for lentivirus manufacturing, exosomes. We have a non-immune library, which is can be very nicely used for all kinds of virus purification or vaccine purification resin development. So to conclude, I hope I demonstrated with the examples provided that our technology platform we've established based on the capture select technology can result in a high purity in a single capture step for new molecular modalities, right? That we can indeed reduce process steps and develop platform processes for these new therapeutic modalities. And besides that we are an integrated company which can move from the initial target and concept and idea up to finally delivering a resin which is suitable for GMP processes. And with that, I would like to take questions.
Okay, great. Thanks, Lars. So the first question is, how do you guarantee security of supply for the ligands?
Yeah, excellent question. So the ligands are manufactured in our facility in the Netherlands. But about 2 years ago, we invested in another facility. So we now have as well the ability, and we are already doing that, is we're manufacturing in another Thermo Fisher Scientific facility in Vilnius, Lithuania, so as well in the European Union, where we as well can supply these type of products. So we're basically dual sourced as a technology, which indeed provides sufficient security of supply for these type of products.
And what documentation and support is provided for regulatory quality?
Yeah, so what we do for all of our products, once they are have moved into the final work package 5 and have been developed as a product which is suitable for GMP, yeah, we compile a comprehensive regulatory support file which contains all information on how the product is being manufactured from the ligand side as well as from the resin side. We include tox testing, a master and working cell bank testing, validation of assays, and that all is compiled in a very lengthy regulatory support file which can be used to submit together with a drug substance.
And with customs, what backbones can be used for commercial manufacturing?
Yeah, so within Thermo Fisher Scientific, we've got two options as a backbone currently. One is based upon agarosis, and the other one is based upon poros as a resin. Usually, we look at the target and which backbone to use. If it's a more, higher molecular weight target, we would use poros. If it is a lower molecular weight target, we would use agarose. But in principle, you know, we've got two commercial backbones which are suitable for GMP manufacturing. And in that sense, we as well are quite unique as a supplier of these type of products.
And what about cleaning or caustic resistance?
Yeah, so cleaning and caustic resistance is dependent upon the affinity ligand we've developed. So some of our products can withstand caustic cleaning, others do not. So for other products, you might want to use acid cleaning, which as well is an accepted cleaning methodology and be used for commercial purification resin cleaning. So usually we've got a couple of options to clean and cycle the product.
Okay. Well, it looks like we have time for just one more question. As a reminder, if Lawrence did not get to your question, we will be sending all the questions that are submitted to him, and he can follow up with you directly. So go ahead and continue to type your questions in. But the last one for the webcast is, are there products available to measure the ligand leakage?
Yes, so absolutely. So once we have developed products which go into GMP processes, we always will launch a accompanying leakage ELISA kit, which can determine the leached ligand, just as simple as people now do with protein A. So it's basically based upon the same principle, and it will specifically detect the ligand which is on a specific resin. Yeah, that is always a commercially available product from our website.
Okay, great. Thanks, Lawrence.
Okay, thanks a lot for listening.
And the recorded version of this webcast will be available for on-demand viewing on our website. And as a registered attendee, you'll receive a follow-up email providing us a direct link. We look forward to having you join us at future Bioprocess International Ask the Expert webcasts. Look for those announcements in your inbox. Goodbye.